Yeah! Package from China! Alright guys, so we can say that nowadays we're having the new generation of Pandora's boxes. But for the people who are not familiar with the product, let's do a quick unboxing. So inside the packaging itself of most of these Pandora's boxes, what you're going to get is the very thick deluxe manual. With some basic explanations. This version comes with the Pandora Games 3D Plus. More over that in a later part of the video. It comes with a very long HDMI cable for connection. You can use this USB cable. USB cables connecting the Pandora box to your game system. We're having some spare parts and of course the ball tops, because we need to have a minor assembly over here. And of course the power supply. Depends where you're going to buy it, because this is just a basic power supply European connection. So inside the packaging itself, you will see that we don't have the ball top. Again, we need to assemble these myself, because the packaging itself is a slightly different with the first models. But let's talk about the buttons, because this is a new version and a completely new layout. So with this Pandora's box version, I do like the art itself. It's more of course a personal taste, but I think it's pretty cool. And normally we're going to get more like these decals from familiar games, but this time we're going to get custom art, and I like it. So these Pandora boxes are made completely different compared with the older models. You can say that these are the Pandora box slim editions, because the casing is not as bulky anymore. They are not, let's say, made of plastic or something. They're just made of metal like the previous models. But in the end, when you're looking at it, they play in slightly better and they are more portable. Yeah, portable and more like in a slim way. Alright, so let's grab the spare parts. I'm also going to give you a 2-in-1 screwdriver. Yeah. Then we're having the ball tops over here. The special caps that we're going to need, and some spare buttons. The spare buttons, I'm very happy they are always going to give you some, simply because if you have any problems, you can swap them out very easily. We'll show you in the video how you need to do this. Okay, so first things first, let's put this duct cap on. Then we're going to use the ball top. Yep, do it like that. Oh yeah. Okay, so when the ball tops are on the joysticks, you need to tighten them up over here. There's no rubbery over here, it's just an open compartment. You can tighten them up like this, and that's it. Okay, so let's do a quick overview of the bottom of the casing itself. As you can see over here, we're having the speaker that is here. I'll be going to open it up and going to show you inside what kind of speaker we're going to use. And of course, we're going to have the rubber feet for giving some grip on the table. With the Pandora box slim, we need to open it up differently with the previous model. So we're having three screws over here, already removed two of them, and at the back we're having some screws. Then we can lift up the top panel. Okay, then we're having the one over here and the other one is over there. So it's not a big of a deal in my opinion, but something you need to take in consideration when you're getting a slim version, that it is slightly difficult than open it up and replacing buttons, because everything is just attached to the top panel. So at the back we're having the on and off switch over here. Then we're having the input for the power supply, HDMI out, VGA out. And we're having here the audio out, volume control, setting button. And we're having two USB ports, and one can be used for controllers. Yes, so we can basically use for player mode. I'm not the biggest fan of this construction, simply because if you need to replace a button, it is always very annoying. Everything is attached to the top plate. As you can see, there's not a lot of parts in this, but there are some differences that I want to talk about. So normally they are going to use this completely cable tree that goes into the IDA connection and will hook up all the controls. But they didn't choose for this because this system has the lighter feature. Okay, so the way they created this is something completely different. Normally they're going to connect the cables from the IDA connector straight into the buttons, but as you can see, we're having this ribbon cable goes to the PCB over here and all the buttons are connected over there. So it's quite an interesting, unique way. They're still having the Sunwell clone joysticks in this version. Okay, so here we're having the Pandora Game 3D mainboard. It's just the same casing like always, but you can see over here, here we're having the EDA connection. It's quite interesting. I've never seen this before in all the Pandora's box. Here we're having the EDA cable. This goes to player 2, this one goes to player 1, and this is the antenna for the Wi-Fi option. Let's take a close look under the cooling element. The cooler itself is not really completely new. It's a new thing on this mainboard, because the previous model was made from copper. And this is just, let's say, more like a basic version. The fan itself is not like a vacuum cleaner, so that's a positive one. It's an AMLogic S8 on a 12B. So it is basically the same that I've used in previous models like the Pandora Game X or the Pandora Game 3D. Alright, so here at the right side we're having 4 chips in total, if I'm saying it correctly, it's 2 GB of RAM. But I understand that this is exactly the same RAM with like the previous models. But we're going to do a compare in the future. Okay, so this is the 4800, I'm guessing this is more like having different and more games. Still using everything on an SD card that we use wooden glue to put in place. And this thing has Wi-Fi capabilities for the Naughty Store. Okay, so here we're having the speaker itself. Most of the time they are giving us a 3 or 5 watt. This is connected straight up here on the main board. And I think it's a pretty genius and easy way. So if you want to, for example, put this main board in your arcade one up. And as you can see over here, the on and off switch goes straight into this board. And that is just for powering on the system on and off. Okay, so with the Slim Edition, we have exactly the same layout as like all the other Pandora's boxes. So to begin with, this is the 6-button edition with light-up buttons. As you can see over here, we have the start, coin, pause, select, and this is only when you want to use the stick itself on the game system. Okay, so the pause button is a very convenient way. It's not applied with every Pandora's box, not all of them, only the latest version have this menu where you can quick load, quick save and go out of the menu. Out of menu option will be with other versions, but the quick load, quick save, this is new. So the joystick. It's more like the cheap Wickel Sanwa joystick clones that we're going to get with most of these Pandora boxes, or you need to buy the Sanwa version because there are factories out there or companies selling these with real Sanwa joysticks, and that is a big improvement, but it will play just fine. I did play some games with it and I did notice that my moves come out very easy, but in the end, I really prefer a good joystick because this is just the perfect arcade experience. So let's talk about the light up buttons. With light up buttons, we have quite some different versions out there when it comes to the quality. And this is not the quality that I like. I know in many ways why. If you're looking at the touch itself, it got a quite short travel. It doesn't have any click whatsoever. But the reason I don't like it, these are basically two reasons. So when you zoom in and you press the button, you can see the LEDs beneath the button. That is the first thing I don't like. With high quality buttons, most of the time you're going to get, even when you're touching it, you don't see the LEDs itself. And another thing is, look at this. This is what we call a very cheap, I don't know why they are selling it like this, and it's all more like a cost effective thing, but this is what we call the wiggle button. Yeah. I want to point out we're also having the 8-button version. For Pandora Games 3D Plus and 3D version, we don't need 8-button because the Pandora box itself only supports 6-button layout. The 8-button, especially when you're having a Pandora box DX inside and when you're having an option like plugging into PlayStation 3 that we can play with all the 8-buttons. So in the end, 6 buttons is more than enough. So fun fact is with the Pandora box nowadays, most of them are using exactly the same menu, only at the right top corner we're going to get a different logo. This is the Pandora Game 3D, or the Pandora Game 3D Plus, I must say, the improved edition with some minor improvements. Okay, so here we're having the all list. That's the shitty list in my opinion, because if you want to search something, it's just a freaking nightmare. Go make where we categorized. So this device runs PSP, PlayStation 1, N64, NES, Super NES, Game Boy Advance, Game Boy Color and Game Boy Classic, Mega Drive. We're having PC Engine. And also we're having Sega Dreamcast, but need to take consideration that the lowest of like Arcade and Neo Geo will run just fine, but the PSP and Sega Dreamcast is just problematic. When it comes to PlayStation, finally we're having some mainboard that runs it pretty decent, but it is not perfect. And yeah, the same goes for N64. It's just mixed bag in my opinion. Then we're having the recent list, so we can check out which game you have played. There's only one page that he saves this. And then we have of course the search option. That is something you really want to have. Otherwise it's just a freaking nightmare to search. Okay, and here we're going to find some new and minor improvements. To begin with, we have the key settings. This is just all the other options that we have in the previous models. Coin settings, exit mode, auto exit. The quality optimization is slightly different than with other Pandora boxes. We're having disabled, or we're having the original, we're having HD, we're having scanline. The option itself, I'm a big fan of it because it doesn't imply with every single system. It did have some issues with it, but you can see that it runs very well. So here we're having different languages, enter game settings, here we can change out some information like the difficulty, credits, etc, etc. The game market, this is what we call the Naughty Store, that's the reason why we're having the Wi-Fi capabilities, but it doesn't work perfectly in my opinion. Account management, here we can change the system password, reset password and clear the coins if you want to use this in a real arcade machine. And last but not least, we're also having a turbo fire function. As you can see, we're having 5 times per second, 10 times per second. So we have quite some different options. The Wi-Fi for the Naughty Store. Then we're having the factory data reset. Don't mess too much with it. And then let's check out another thing that's quite interesting. That's the gamepad settings and the gamepad utility widget. And this is what we're going to need if you want to connect it for, let's say, to a system like the PC. Another thing is quite interesting when you want to use it with an other, let's say, different controller. So you want to play 4 players, we also have the option to do that. So when you go into the gamepad settings, here we can configure the controllers. So when I plug it in, well, it's very cool with the Pandora Games 3D Plus Edition. We're having some more support, like normal controls, like the Microsoft Xbox. When you're pressing right on the joystick, you can see what kind of player you're going to give it. So you can use this thing like, it's just a game system with a controller attached to it. Or you can use it for player 3 and player 4, so you can play games with 4 players.
Hihachi Mishima. Christy Montero. Get ready for the next battle.
Go easy on me.
Round 1. Fight.
Whoa! Whoa, what just happened? Whoa. And you can see this stuff does happen all the time with PSP. Okay, let's try it again. Alright, another try.
Round 1. Fight.
Okay guys, so this is what you're going to get with the Gamebox or the Pandora Game 3D Plus Edition. I'm not a big fan of the buttons, they are feeling very cheap. The response is good, the same goes for the joystick. It does work like a cheap joystick, but I really prefer to have a real semi joystick. The shell itself, I'm not a big fan of it. It's slim, it's indeed, let's say, better compact, and it is more like the better designed than the other version I've reviewed. But in the end, if you're looking at the capabilities, it's still the same story like all the other models I've reviewed. So even if it's the latest version, it's more of the same. Yeah, let me know what you think of this. I want to thank you for watching. Consider subscribing, hit the little bell, and I will see you in the next video.